Sirach 12 and 10. Never trust thy enemy, for like his iron rusted, so is his wickedness. All right, Shalom Akim. I would like to start off by giving our honor and glory to Yahweh, Bahashami, Hawashah, Bahashur, Kakunash. Double honor to our apostles, the great millstone, Ruel, and peace and blessing to the house of David the elect. I'm Zahabin behind the camera.
Abaya.
Hey, today I want to go into the characteristics of Esau, man. Because there's a quote. I want to say a Chinese quote or a Japanese quote. Never trust thy enemy. Know thy enemy, know thyself, and thou shalt fare never the worst. So if you're dealing with opposition, you should know the nature of your opposition, right? The characteristics of your opposition. You can almost predict their moves when you know their nature, all right? The reason why Edomites get attacked by animals also is through spirit, right? Spirit of vengeance. But people subconsciously think that that lion is an extension of them. They subconsciously think that killer whale is an extension of them. And they disregard, it has a nature that's not connected with your nature, all right? And when we as the 12 tribes, we don't understand, Esau came to the shores of America when it came to the tribe of Gad, or even Jacob, or Christianity. Esau has a different nature than you, man. There's a different spirit in him, man, all right? And he has a cap. That's why it says, what, in Genesis 25? Two nations in our womb and two manner of people, man, all right? Esau was what? A cunning hunter. Esau was a cunning hunter. What does a hunter do? He sets traps for your demise. Your demise is his game. All right? We're gonna let the Most High speak. Sirach 12 and 10. Never trust thy enemy, for like his iron rusted, so is his wickedness. Though he humble himself and go crafting, yet take good heed and beware of him, and thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped the looking glass, and thou shalt know that his rust have not been altogether wiped away. Alright? And that's one form of that is Christianity, man. He overthrew you with Christianity. He humbled himself with Christianity, man. Alright? He always has an ulterior motive, man. If Esau's ever friendly to you, that should raise an antenna, man. Alright? Why would he be friendly to you? He doesn't know you. Alright? Set him not by thee. That's when he have overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place, neither let him sit in thy right hand, lest he seek to take thy seat. And thou at the last remember my words and be pricked therewith. Who will pity a charmer that is bending with the serpent? All right? Who will pity Jacob for trusting Esau, man? Esau was a serpent. It refers to him in Revelation 20 as what? That old serpent. Why was he called a serpent? Because he's cunning. Whoa. What did it say about Esau in Genesis 25th chapter? He's a cunning hunter. A serpent is a cunning hunter. Esau dealt with Jake in America like a cunning hunter. He put you in a concentrated environment so it can be easy to track you. And he set traps out for your demise. All right? And he put you in this new form of slavery to prison industrial complex. He hunts you, man. He baits you and he traps you. And that's how he overthrows you, man. He's already conquered you through slavery, but to keep you in that conquered state, man, he traps you. All right? He traps you through sex, then he charges you for your babies in the form of child support, so that keeps you from financially progressing. He traps you through what? Through all these liquor stores. Now you're an incompetent human because you can't go out and function. He traps you through drugs because now you're an incompetent human. You can't go out and function. He traps you through nigger culture and tells every Israelite you can be a successful drug dealer, man. Now you're spending the prime of your life in a goddamn cell, man. Well, he will overthrow you, man. Esau was a cunning hunter. All right? Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with the serpent, or any such as come now wild beast. Or any such as come now wild beast. And Esau's spirit is like that unto a wild beast, man. You have to stop thinking that he's an extension of you. How you move in this earth is how he moves in this earth. No, that's two different energies, man. Two different entities, man. All right? From there, I'm going to get Sirach 13, all right, in verse 9. If thou be invited of a mighty man, withdraw thyself, and so much the more will he invite thee. All right, Esau is very inquisitive, man. All right? And one thing I noticed about Esau has to figure you out to feel better about himself. If you're on a job, and you're quiet, you're a mystery to Esau, Esau can't wrap his mind around what type of man you were. Esau compartmentalized Jakes into categories. If you're a street nigga, he gonna assess you as like, oh, he's one of those crazy black guys. If you're an athlete, he's an athletic black guy. If you're smart, oh, you're one of those nerdy black guys. Esau has to compartmentalize you, man. But the core of it is, Esau has to conquer you. Esau has to be supreme over you, whether it's individual Edomites or Esau as a power structure. Esau has to remain superior. That's why when you have a conversation, Esau loves telling you information, but he doesn't love receiving information from you, because you can't be the giver. He has to be the giver. He's putting you on game. All right, a nigga can't put Esau on information, man. That's the narrative. All right, if thou be invited of a mighty man, withdraw thyself, and so much the more when he invite thee. And I had somebody hit my car, right? I had an Edomite insurance agent. He was asking me questions. He was like, so where was you out of town? You said you went out of town that weekend, it happened to your car? I'm like, yeah. It's like, what did you do that weekend? They would talk about something else. Then he'd go back and ask me the same question, as though I'm gonna switch my house from. He was acting like the coolest Edomite in the world, man. Serpent! So many Jakes have been entrapped into the prison system because they were wrong. They let Esau use his serpent skills to trap them. Like that movie, When They See Us. Those boys, they got finessed. They got deceived by a serpent. He broke their minds down to where they lied on themselves, man. Because Esau was a serpent. A lawyer is like a serpent. An interrogator is like a serpent, man. All right? On social media is like a serpent. Because now Esau uses your ego against you. You putting all your drug money, all your illegal money on camera, and you rattle. The fans is watching, man. All right? Press thou not upon him, lest thou be put back. Stand not far off, lest thou be forgot. Hey, and that's beautiful. Press not upon him, lest thou be put back. Esau doesn't care about that nigga that's all in his face smiling. He already figured you out. But that Jake that's quiet and distant and doesn't really need Esau's validation, Esau has to figure him out, man. Hey, Esau hates confident Jakes, man. You look him in the eye, Esau hates that, man. Because you a man, he's a man, and you're a dominant man. And the things that make him feel secure is that you show some type of allegiance to him, man. Show some type of submission to him, man. All right? That's why Esau has something called microaggressions. Esau does petty things to feel superior, man. I had an Edomite look at me. I'm saying this for edification. I had an Edomite just stare at me, right? Look at me. So I'm on a job, and I speak to him. And guess all he did when I spoke to him? He'll look at me just so I can look at him and speak to him, just so he doesn't speak back but just raise his eyebrows. Why did he do that, man? So he can have the one up on me, man. Mm-hmm. Esau has to have a one up on Jake, whether it's as a nation or personally, man. Know the nature of your enemy. Esau has to always be over you, man. All right? Let me see. Verse 11, affect not to be made equal unto him in talk, and believe not his many words, but with much communication will he tempt thee, and smiling upon thee will get out thy secrets. And that's what Esau does, man. Because when he smiles upon you, he dearms you, and you feel like you're talking to one of the guys. Next thing you know, you're telling him about your wife, you're telling him about your kids. You don't know this man, all right? Because why? Keep this in mind. Esau is a cunning hunter. A cunning hunter, at the end of the day, he wants to overthrow you. And you being overthrown is his game. All right? But verse 12. But cruelly he will lay up thy words and will not spare to do thee hurt and to put thee in prison. Man, hey, that's case closed, man. Hey, but you have any closing statements?
No, bro.
Hey, man, never trust thy enemy. Esau is a personification of a serpent, man. All right? Hey, keep your antennas up. But with that, Shalom.
Shalom, my kid.